the good stuff.
Hey everybody, this is Robert, continuing my blind playthrough of Divinity Original Sin. I'm up here in the marketplace, and for a while now I am probably going to go slowly as I'm trying to explore and see what's going on up here. Here's my journal.
Well, hello there.
Let's see, we met the guards. Okay, that's when we met the orc.
The soul of the average human, I say.
Fire, fire, fire. A ship has been set on fire.
Potions to bemuscle you. Scrolls to...
Okay, this is the big one, I think. We've been sent to investigate the murder. We're supposed to talk to the captain of the Legion in the Legion headquarters. Okay. And let's see. He told us to question the villagers about the murder. Excuse me. And to talk to the Legion captain. Okay. And then there was that weird talking statue thing that made that guy jump off the cliff.
Livestock's got twice the sense and thrice the soul of the average human, I say.
Savagery's in their very blood.
Well,
a good day to you.
Cheese, tomatoes.
I'm not really sure where to go up here. There's a map.
Day on the market, it seems.
This looks like a big area. Harbor warehouse.
Lonesome, spiritless, perhaps resting on earth.
Anything up here?
There's more holes than a slice of this fine Borgenberg.
I don't know. I guess we just need to wander around a little bit. Looks like an important place. What's that?
Beat a big cheese on your block with a wheel of the good stuff.
Let's talk to this guy.
Can I help ya?
His name is Marcius. So this is the town hall, okay. Well, what do you know about the undead plague? So, he's upset they've been stuck in here for 2 years. It was fun and games at the beginning. What about the Legion? Alright, so there's this captain guy we need to talk to. He confers with the wizards and kings. Commands his own regiment. Still don't really know where he is.
Farewell!
Let's go in here and see what's in here. It's a town hall, right? This is the mayor's office?
Can I help you?
Alright, tell me about yourself. Brother Tom. Okay. So, I guess she encouraged him to join the Legion, her brother. He even got him sparring with the captain. Fabulous Five? Some sort of Fabulous Five came into town. It's a band? Well, they're his heroes. So he ran off with the Fabulous Five.
Farewell. Okay.
Could this be the mayor?
Can I help you?
Okay. Tell me about the issues here. What? Very different. So there was the death of Jake by the source magic. They're facing all kinds of other problems. Undead have overrun the northern trade route, and orcs are making a habit of savaging our beaches. That's not to mention that at the top, there's rumors of some religious sect or cult sticking their tendrils into the innocent. So he has a private matter he'd like to bring to our attention. It involves a magic relic I rather foolishly sought. Staff of Pergamon. Alright, well, let's go ahead and with his staff right now. That's only polite. I was expecting a shipment of weapons, and there was a very powerful, very rare staff. And it's gone missing. He fears it may have fallen into the wrong hands, and he wondered if we could get it for him. Well, tell us about it. What do you know about it? The staff contains a shard of an orc, highly valued for its use in the weapons of war. I know the use of the material to be forbidden, but I was desperate to do something to aid the townfolk against the undead. Alright, so there was a merchant. Tell me about this merchant. His name is Comrade, Captain of the Tide Spitter. His ship still docked at the harbor, and we can talk with him if we think it might help. Alright, well, let's talk about Jake's murder. So he and the counselor had their differences, but most of the townsfolks are certain that Jake's wife, Esmeralda, is responsible. In fact, the Legion have taken her into protective custody to keep her safe from the mob. He's known Esmeralda for years. That business between her and the Duke was always a bit suggestive. But I never had cause to suspect of her violence. Still, one never knows for sure. Alright, tell me about the Duke. Well, he's an upright bloke. Apart from all this Esmeralda nonsense, the whole town knows that the only goal of his business trips was to spend the night or two at the King Crab Inn with Mrs. Counselor. Alright, what about the undead? For the past 2 years, they've suffocated the city with all but one trade route overrun. Our commerce has really slowed to a pathetic trickle. How about these these cults or something? Can you tell me about them? Let's see, can you tell me more about your library? That depends. What kind of berries are you interested in exactly? Okay, this guy can't hear. Ah, the library. Would you like to have a look? I'll escort you upstairs. Sure. Follow me.
Farewell.
Really anywhere to, what's that, teleporter pyramid. Okay, it's interesting. I don't know what that is. Oh, it's locked. I can't get in there. All right, well, let's follow him upstairs. This is the library, the beacon of culture and learning. My Victoria has every volume you could possibly imagine. Victoria's come a long way from a little bundle of claws and teeth. Is he talking about the cat? So, let's see. Said Victoria will be happy to make our acquaintance.
The lesser key of Sadakandras. What nonsense. The Encyclopedia Daemonium. I know it by heart.
Who's this?
Demonology for dumbbells.
That's Victoria.
I need something more advanced. The Pseudomonarchia Daemonium.
Can I help you?
The first edition too.
Victoria.
Most promising.
Let's ask, who are you? My daughter? I can't tell what she is. She was cast out from her tribe. It's found in a wicker basket. She's an orc, okay. So they took pity, and... Alright. Taught me the language and customs. She became the city's librarian, okay. May I take books from the library? Indeed you may. The wisdom I hear hoard is yours to pursue and even take with you. All I ask is that you return the books you borrow, so that others may enjoy them too.
Farewell.
The Encyclopedia of Daemonium.
Who placed this book here?
Who's this guy?
No. Can I help you?
I don't know. We are interrupting him. So we obviously don't look like the regular folk around here. And he knows we're source hunters. A stalker of sorcery, chaser of charms. I cannot go so far as to say it is a pleasure to make your acquaintance, for I take no pleasure in the company of man. Aren't you a man? No. But it may be to our mutual advantage to join forces. Well, why would we do that? Well, you hunt the source, and I hunt demons. You are aware, of course, that often both of these pests frequent the same shadowy pools of infamy. Now, I hate what I hunt, but I respect its cunning, should I not? I'd been decimated, body and soul, long since. Okay. Let there be strength and cunning, but also in numbers. The calculus of wizardry I offer you. So, he's another wizard. Looks like his little staff is glowing different than Scarlet's there. So if we want to join forces, he says there's one condition. You'll never deal with demonic entities. Give me your word. Very well. No deals with demons. And of course the cleric is going to agree with that. Agreed. Most gratifying. Well, we got a new buddy in the party. Let's take a look at his skills. He's got some healing and rain. What does that do besides put out fire? Well, let's I don't really know if there's anything else to do around here.
Princess Buttercup with the flushing foot. Send your deck in.
Let's head out of here. I think I'll stop this video here. We'll continue to explore in the next one. Thanks for watching, everybody.